students, I welcome you to the science video session of standard 5. Today we are going to learn about conservation of animals.
Animals are multicellular eukaryotic organisms. Animals consume organic material, breathe oxygen, able to move, can reproduce sexually. Come on students, let us learn about asexual reproduction. Asexual reproduction is a type of reproduction that does not involve the fusion of gametes or change in the number of chromosomes.
Come on students, let's learn some important terms and their meanings. Sexual reproduction, sexual, S-E-X-U-A-L, sexual reproduction, R-E-P-R-O-D-U-C-T-I-O-N. Sexual reproduction is the production of new living organisms by combining genetic information from two individuals of different types. The production of new living organisms by combining genetic information from two individuals of different types is known as sexual reproduction. Asexual reproduction, A-S-E-X-U-A-L, asexual reproduction, R-E-P-R-O-D-U-C-T-I-O-N. Asexual reproduction means it does not involve sex cells or fertilization. Only one parent is required. Asexual reproduction does not involve sex cells or fertilization. Only one parent is required. V-E-T-E-R-I-N-K-R-Y. Vector means relating to the diseases, injuries and treatment of farm and domestic animals. Relating to the diseases, injuries and treatment of farm and domestic animals is veterinary. Conservation, C-O-N-S-E-R-V-A-T-I-O-N. Conservation means the careful preservation and protection of natural resource. Careful preservation and protection of natural resources known as conservation. Preservation, P-R-E-S-E-R-V-A-T-I-O-N, preservation. Protection, P-R-O-P-E-C-T-I-O-N, protection. Extinction, E-S-T-I-N-C-T-I-O-N, extinction means there aren't very many of the type of animal left in the world. There aren't very many of the type of animal left in the world. This is the meaning of extinction. Poaching, P-O-A-C-H-I-N-G. Poaching is the illegal hunting or capturing of wild animals. Poaching is illegal hunting or capturing of wild animals. Survey, S-U-R-V-E-Y, survey. Survey means in order to collect data for the analysis of some aspect of a group or area. In order to collect data for the analysis of some aspect of a group or area is survey. So, you learn the meanings for extension, poaching, survey. Come on students, let's learn about asexual reproduction. A-S-E-X-U-A-L, R-E-P-R-O-P-U-C-T-I-O-N. The type of reproduction in which only a single parent is taking place is that is asexual reproduction. It gets divided into two new offspring is known as asexual reproduction. It takes place in microorganisms like Hydra and Amoeba. It produces offspring that are identical to the parent. There are several ways by which animals reproduce. The below topics are explained about asexual reproduction. Come on students, let's learn about fission. F-I-S-S-I-O-N, fission. Fission occurs when some invertebrate and multicell organisms. Invertebrate means organism without backbone. So invertebrates are organisms without backbone. In this method, an organism split itself into two parts. Example, flatworms, sea anemones and sea cucumber. Students, now we are seeing flatworms. F-L-A-T-W-O-R-M-S. This flatworms can reproduce through a process called fission. In this process, a worm breaks off a portion of tissue from the back end of its body, and this portion regenerates to form a complete worm. They found that the frequency of fission events correlated with the size of the parent animal. Now you see students, the flatworm divided into head, trunk and tail. So this head again regenerates free. Trunk again regenerates free. This tail again regenerates free. Regeneration is producing new leaf. So all these three parts, from these three parts again new flatworm can grow. So this is fission reproduction. So this belongs to asexual reproduction of flatworms. Students, now we are seeing sea cucumber. S-E-A-C-U-C-U-M-B-E-R. Sea cucumber is shown by releasing eggs and sperm into the water, where the eggs are fertilized during spawning. Sea cucumbers develop a cobra-like appearance with their front end raised up from the bottom. So it looks like cobra. Students, now we are seeing sea anemone. S-E-A-A-N-E-M-O-N-E. So this you can see only in the sea, so that it is known as sea anemone. It's a mode of fission which involves the spreading of the petal disc and the degradation of tissue between the margin of the petal disc and the body column. This produces crescent-shaped fragments, present is moon-shaped fragments, which then regenerate into fully formed polyps. So, in sea anemone, asexual mode of reproduction takes place is fission. Those are divided into two halves and regenerate the other half in each of the resulting individuals.
Regenerate, R-E-G-E-N-E-R-A-T-E. Regenerate means regeneration is termed as an asexual mode of reproduction. It is common in unicellular organisms and lower multicellular organisms such as planaria. Here the organism fragments when it is ready to reproduce. And new organisms are regenerated from the fragmented parts.
Students, now we are seeing the picture of binary fission and multiple fission. So this fission is one of the asexual reproduction. So it takes place in this organism. Now what is binary fission? Binary fission is asexual reproduction by the separation of the body into new bodies. In the process of binary fission, an organism duplicates its genetic material or DNA. Capital D, capital N, capital A. DNA means deoxyribonucleic nucleic acid and then divides into two parts with each new organelle receiving one copy of DNA. Here you see students, you are seeing two flagellate. So from this each one divides and then new organism arises. So amoeba, trypanosome, flagellate, paramecium. So this is an example of binary fission. Students, now we are going to see budding. B-U-D-D-I-N-G. So this budding is a mode of asexual reproduction. It takes place in Hydra and Corals. Budding in biology, a form of asexual reproduction in which a new individual develops from generative anatomical point of the parent of DNA. Budding is a form of a sexual reproduction that results from the outgrowth of a part of the body. Then the bud is separated from the original organism, forming two individuals. Budding occurs commonly in some invertebrate animals such as hydras and corals. See student, this is corals. C-O-R-A-L-S. Corals can reproduce asexually and sexually through budding. New corals bud off from parent corals to form new colonies. In fragmentation, an entire colony branches off to form a new colony. Once attached, they metamorphose into a coral polyp and begin to grow, dividing in half. Students, now we are seeing Hydra, H-Y-D-R-A. Budding in Hydra involves a small bud which is developed from its parent Hydra through the repeated mitotic division of its cells. The small bud then receives its nutrition from the parent Hydra and grows healthy. Growth starts by developing small tentacles on the mouth. See students, from budding, a new Hydra arises. Fragmentation, F-R-A-G-M-E-N-T-A-T-I-O-N. Fragmentation is the breaking of an individual into parts followed by regeneration. Regeneration means it is the breaking of an individual parts followed by regeneration. Reproduction through fragmentation is observed in sponges and sea stars. Student, this is sponge. The typical means of asexual reproduction is either fragmentation where a piece of the sponge breaks off, settles on a new substrate and develops into a new individual, or budding, the genetically identical outgrowth from the parent eventually detaches or remains attached to form a colony. See student, this is starfish. Fragmentation, F-R-A-G-M-E-N-T-A-T-I-O-N. Fragmentation is spirogyra, S-P-I-R-O-G-Y-R-A. This fragmentation is the process or state of breaking or being broken into. Fragmentation may occur through accidental damage from predators, or as a natural form of reproduction. Spores. Spores is one type of asexual reproduction. Come on students, let us learn about spore. Spore is a reproductive cell capable of developing into a new individual without fusion with another reproductive cell. Spores are agents of asexual reproduction, whereas gametes are agents of sexual reproduction. Spores are produced by bacteria, fungi, algae and plants. Come on students, let us learn about spores formation in fungi. Fungus spores are microscopic biological particles that allow the fungi to be reproduced, serving a similar purpose to that of seeds in the plant world. Fungi decompose organic waste and are essential for recycling of carbon and minerals in our ecosystem. See students how this force can be reproduced. Subtropical zone, bacteria, plants and fungi reproduce via spores. Spores are the structures naturally grown as part of an organism's life cycle. They are separated from the organism and dispersed through a medium such as air or water. In a suitable environment, the spores develop into a fully grown organism. Protozoa. Now you are seeing the picture of protozoan. PROTOZOAN. The sporozoans also named because they form dormant bodies called spores during one phase of their life cycle. Protozoa occur widely in nature, particularly in aquatic environments. Come on students, let us learn about spores and bacteria. One of the most common coping mechanisms for bacteria is forming pores to protect themselves against ecological degrading agents. Bacteria's pores are the most dormant form of bacteria since they exhibit minimal metabolism and respiration as well as reduced enzyme production. Hey students, now we are seeing spores in plants. Spores are the reproductive structure of the lower plants. Plants that don't flower, fungi, algae and even some bacteria all form spores when they want to pass their genes on. They think of them like the seeds. They are made to grow a new plant and all they need is the proper environment to thrive. Come on students, let's go to our lab to see the specimen of Hydra, sea cucumber, etc.
See students, you are seeing the specimen of mushroom. A mushroom or toadstool is the fleshy, spore-bearing, fruiting body of a fungus, typically produced above ground, on soil, or on its food source. These gills produce microscopic spores that help the fungus spread across the ground or its open surface.
Student, this is sponges. Sponges reproduce through fragmentation.
See students, you are seeing the specimen of sponge. Sponges are multicellular organisms that have bodies full of pores and channels allowing water to circulate through them. Students, now you are seeing starfish. Asexual reproduction in starfish takes place by fission or through autonomy of arms. In fission, the central disc breaks into two pieces and each portion then regenerates the missing parts. Students, now you are seeing the specimen of Hydra. Hydra, when food is plentiful, many Hydra reproduce asexually by budding. The buds form from the body wall, grow into miniature adults and break away when mature. When a Hydra is well fed, a new bud can form every 2 days. Student, this is coral. A coral reef is an underwater ecosystem characterized by reef building corals. Reefs are formed of colonies of coral polyps held together by calcium carbonate. Most coral reefs are built from stony corals whose polyps cluster in groups.
Come on students, let us learn about endangered species. ENDANGERED species, SPECIES. An endangered species is an animal or a plant that is at the risk of extinction. It means that they might extinct from the earth soon. It is reported that nearly 132 species of plants and animals are critically endangered in India. Snow leopard, Bengal tiger, Asiatic lion, turkey frog and Indian giant squirrel are some of the endangered animals in India. See student, this is snow leopard. It is also known as ounce. O-U-N-C-E, ounce. The snow leopard is also known as ounce. Is a large cat native of the mountain ranges of Central and South Asia. The young baby of a snow leopard is called a cub. C-U-B, cub. A snow leopard group is called a leap. L-E-A-P. Group of snow leopard is known as leap. You are seeing Bengal tiger. B-E-N-G-A-L. Bengal tiger. T-I-G-E-R. The Bengal tiger is a tiger from a specific population of the Tantra tigris. It is threatened by poaching, loss and fragmentation of habitat. Students, which is known as king of forest? Very good. It is lion. Asiatic lion. Asiatic lions are slightly smaller than African lions. Adult males weigh 160 to 190 kg. Adult male weighs 160 kg to 190 kg. Females weigh from 110 to 120 kg. The height of the shoulder. Shoulder's height is about 3.5 feet. Students, now we are seeing purple frog. See the color of the frog. It is purple in color. P-U-R-P-L-E. Purple frog. F-R-O-G. Frog. Purple frog. It is found in the western ghats in India. Names in English that have been used for this species are purple frog, Indian purple frog or pignose frog. See the nose, it is looking like pignose. So it is also known as pignose frog. Students, now we are seeing Indian giant squirrel. Indian giant squirrel is a Malabar giant squirrel. Is a large free squirrel species. See, it is very big in size. Endemic to forest and woodlands in India. It is a diurnal, arboreal and mainly herbivorous squirrel. So herbivorous animals means they will eat only plants. Similarly, plants like umbrella tree, Malabar tree, Rafflesia flower, Indian mallow and muslin plant are endangered. See students, now we are seeing umbrella tree. So why it is known as umbrella means it is giving shade. This umbrella tree, U-M-B-R-E-L-L-A, umbrella tree, T-R-E-E, tree, is a native to tropical rainforest and rainforest in India. Students, now you are seeing Malabar glory lily plant. So this Gloryella is a medicinal plant, belongs to the family Liliaceae. It is the national flower of Zimbabwe and the state flower of Tamil Nadu. So which is the state flower of Tamil Nadu students? So this Malabar Glory Lily flower. So it is a semi the herbaceous branch flower reaching approximately 5 meters high with brilliant wavy edged yellow and red color flowers. See, you can see yellow and red color flowers. So it will grow up to 5 meters high. The plant will grow up to 5 meters high. Students, now we are seeing Rafflesia flower. Rafflesia, R-A-F-F-L-E-S-I-A, Rafflesia flower. The species have enormous flowers, the bud rising from the ground or directly from the lowest stem of their host plants. One species has the largest flower in the world. So which is the largest flower in the world? It is Rafflesia flower. Students, now we are seeing Indian mallow flower. It is native to tropic and subtropic regions and sometimes cultivated as ornamental. So this flower is used for ornamentation purpose. It is found in Karnataka and Tamil Nadu. This plant is often used as a medicinal plant and is considered on certain tropical islands. Do you know, students, an animal is said to be endangered if its population is currently less than 50 or less than 250 for the past 3 years. So, what are the causes for this endangered, students? Come on, let us learn the cause for endangered in plants and animals. The following are the reasons why an animal or a plant is endangered or extinct. Forests which provide food and shelter to animals are destroyed for human race. Large number of animals is hunted for their horns.
Horn, let's go horn. See the picture, students, you can see the horn of animals. Horn are a permanent outgrowth, often curved and pointed, found in parts on the head of cattle, sheep, goats, giraffe, etc.
Skin,
S-K-I-N. Look at the skin of animal, students. A hide or skin is an animal skin treated for human use. The word hide is related to the German word haut, H-A-U-T, which means skin. The industry defines hide as skin of large animals. Common commercial hides include leather from cattle and other livestock animals, alligator skin, snake skin, etc.
Teeth,
T-E-E-T-H. See the teeth of animal, students. A tooth is a hard, calcified structure found in the jaws of many vertebrates and used to break down food. Some animals, particularly carnivores, also use teeth for hunting and for defensive purpose.
And many other valuable products. Do you know, in the recent years, more number of animals affected by waste in the form of plastic? Animals mistake plastic as their food and eat them. Surgeons in Tamil Nadu, Veterinary University, Chennai, have removed 52 kg of plastic from a cow.
Plastic, P-L-A-S-T-I-C, plastic. Look at the substance, students. These substances are known as plastic materials. This plastic refers to the material used in a wide range of synthetic or semi-synthetic products that incorporate polymers.
Pollutions like air pollution and water pollution affect the animals.
Pollution. See, students, how pollution has been generated in the environment.
Pollution is the introduction of contaminants into the natural environment that cause adverse change. Pollution can take the form of chemical substances or energy such as noise, heat or light. Pollutants, the components of pollution can either foreign substances or energies or naturally occurring constituents. See the picture, students, you can see how the air is getting polluted. Air pollution, AIRPOLLUTION. Air pollution is a mixture of solid particles and gases in the air, car emissions, chemicals from factories, dust, pollen, etc. Ozone, a gas, is a major part of air. Pollution in cities, when ozone forms air pollution, it is also called smog, SMOG. Some air pollutants are poisonous. WATER, water pollution, POLLUTION. See students how the water gets polluted. Water pollution is the contamination of water bodies, usually as a result of human activities. Water bodies include, for example, lakes, rivers, oceans, aquifers and groundwater. Water pollution results when contaminants are introduced into the natural environment.
Sometimes animals are taken to a new habitat by people. They cannot survive there.
Habitat, H-A-B-I-T-A-T, habitat, the natural home or environment of animal, plant or other organism is known as habitat.
Pesticides and chemicals which are used to get rid of insects, pests or weeds poison the plants and animals.
Pesticide, P-E-S-T-I-C-I-D-E, a substance used for destroying insects or other organisms harmful to cultivated plants or to animals is known as pesticide.
Natural disasters like flood.
Flood, F-L-O-O-D, flood. A flood is an overflow of water that submerges land that is usually dry. In the sense of flowing water, the word may also be applied to the inflow of the tide.
Cyclones.
Cyclones. C-Y-C-L-O-N-E-S. Cyclones. Cyclone is a system of winds rotating inwards to an area of low barometric pressure with an anti-clockwise or clockwise circulation that is creating a depression.
And fire also destroys animals.
Fire. F-I-R-E. Fire. Fire is the rapid oxidation of a material in the exothermic chemical process of combustion of releasing heat, light and various other products.
Come on, friends, let us learn how to save the endangered species. Nature is beautiful and it is filled with varieties of plants and animals, but they are endangered mainly due to human activities. We need to take some measures to protect them. Hunting and poaching animals should be prohibited.
Hunting, H-U-N-T-I-N-G. Hunting is the activity of hunting wild animals or it is like a game. Poaching, P-O-A-C-H-I-N-G. Poaching is the illegal hunting, capturing and often killing of wild animals. Other activities such as killing a wild or protected animal without a license in a prohibited manner is known as poaching.
We should not pollute the environment. Limited the usage of plastic recycling it can save the endangered animals. Pesticides and chemicals which pollute the environment should be avoided. Planting native trees will provide food to the animals. We should buy eco-friendly products only.
Endangered species. Each and every animal on earth has as much right to be here as you and me. Shoot us with the cameras, not guns. Earth was created for all of us, not some of us. Animals cannot be manufactured. Once they are gone, they cannot be replaced. Today's endangered animals are in danger, but later on, human beings will be in danger. So these are slogans of endangered species. Come on students, let's learn about the native plants.
See students, we have to be very kind to animals. Do you know Project Tiger was initiated in India in 1972 to protect the Bengal tiger? It was launched on 1st April 1973. Due to this project, the population of tiger has increased in India from 1400 in 2006 to 2967 in 2018. Come on students, let us learn about Red Data Book. The Red Data Book is a book maintained for recording rare and endangered species of animals and plants. This book is created to identify and protect the species which are about to extinct.
See students, you are seeing the red data book. Different colors are used. Black color indicates confirmed to extinct species. Red color indicates endangered species. White color indicates rare species. Green color indicates formerly endangered species but started to recover. What is asexual reproduction? The type of reproduction in which only a single parent gets divided into two new offspring is known as asexual reproduction. Mention the different types of asexual reproduction: fission, budding, fragmentation, spores are the different types of asexual reproduction. What is a red data book? The red data book is a book maintained for recording rare and endangered species of animals and plants. Detailed question. Explain the methods of asexual reproduction. The type of reproduction in which only a single parent gets divided into two new offspring is known as asexual reproduction. This type of reproduction takes place in microorganisms like Hydra and amoeba. Asexual reproduction produces offspring that are identical to the parent. There are several ways by which animals reproduce asexually. Some of them are explained below. First one, fission. F-I-S-S-I-O-N. Fission. Fission occurs in some invertebrates. Invertebrates are organisms without backbone. Multicell organisms. In this method, an organism split itself into two parts. For example, flatworms, sea anemones and sea cucumbers divide into two halves and regenerate the other half in each of the resulting individuals. Budding, B-U, budding. Budding is a form of asexual reproduction that results from the outgrowth of a part of the body. Then the bud is separated from the original organism, forming two individuals. Budding occurs commonly in some invertebrate animals such as hydras and corals. Fragmentation, fragmentation. Fragmentation is the breaking of an individual into parts followed by regeneration. Reproduction through fragmentation is observed in sponges and sea stars. Fragmentation may occur through accidental damage, damage from predators, or as a natural form of reproduction. Spores, S-P-O-R-E-S, spores. Some protozoan, bacteria, plants and fungi reproduce via spores. Spores are the structures naturally grown as part of an organism's life cycle. They are separated from the organism and dispersed through a medium such as air or water. In a suitable environment, the spores will develop into a fully grown organism. Students, you are seeing the diagram of Hydra. Hydra reproduce by budding. So, you see the development of bud. Tentacles. Draw this diagram in your note.
See students, this diagram explains asexual reproduction in Hydra. Hydra reproduce through budding. See students, from the parent Hydra, a new bud arises and then it grows. So, this fully grown Hydra will separate from the parent and it grow individually. So, this is bud and this part is known as tentacles. T-E-N-T-A-C-L-E-S, tentacles. So, you are seeing the picture of asexual reproduction in Hydra. Hydra reproduction takes place by budding. Asexual reproduction. Under asexual reproduction, we learn the methods such as fission, fragmentation, spores, budding, etc. We also learn about endangered species, how to protect the endangered species. We learn about Red Delta book.
Thank you, students.